This video is based on Manta Ray's optimization algorithm. Topics covered in this video. First, we have basic introduction about this algorithm. What is this algorithm all about and the main inspiration behind this algorithm. Different mathematical models used in this algorithm and various steps. Manta rays are the fancy creatures like this. As you can see, this is the basic structure for the manta rays. You can see eye position, mouth, lobes, fins, and tail. Manta rays forcing optimization algorithm is a bio-inspired optimization technique, and this algorithm is inspired by the intelligent forcing strategies of manta rays. And we can use this algorithm to solve different optimization problems. Basic introduction about manta rays. As we know, they are the fancy creatures and they come in the category of fish. Their lifespan is about 50 years, size about 29 feet, weight about 1350 kg. That is the largest manta ray. And their diet, they eat plankton, and an adult manta ray can eat 5 kg planktons per day. Here you can see we have two species for manta rays, reef manta ray and the giant manta ray. Reef manta ray width about 5.5 and giant manta ray width about 7 meters. And they have the largest brain among all. And giant manta rays are found in high temperature ocean, in tropical and subtropical oceans. And reef manta rays are found in Indian oceans. Here you can see we have three intelligent foraging strategies used by manta rays: chain foraging, cyclone foraging, and somersault foraging. Let's see one by one. First, we have chain foraging. In this foraging strategy, manta rays formed an ordinary line, suppose like this. This is an intelligent foraging strategy used by manta rays. They formed an ordinary line. 50 or more manta rays start foraging. They line up one behind another. Manta rays, first they will observe plankton's position and swim toward it. As you can see, they form a chain by line up from head to tail. You can see from head to tail. Here, assume that the best solution is plankton with high concentration that manta ray want to approach. So best solution is here, target that manta rays want to approach. And in every iteration, all individuals will update their position with respect to the solution in front of it and the best solution found. Here, they are using this strategy. If this manta ray missed any plankton, then the one behind can easily catch it. Here the goal is to intake maximum food. So you can see the search strategy, if any manta missed the target, then the one behind another can easily catch it. And this is the mathematical model used for this strategy. Here this is the individual position, best position, that is the plankton with high concentration, and this is the weight coefficient. R is the random value that is normally distributed within the domain 0 and 1. Second strategy is cyclone foraging. Now suppose concentration of planktons is very high. Here dozens of manta rays gather together in a cyclone like structure, as you can see here. So when the plankton concentration is very high, manta rays gather together like cyclone structure for the foraging, and and they form a long forcing chain and swim toward the target by spiral. Here each manta ray moves toward the one in front of it and also move toward the food in spiral bay. As you can see, they form a spiral-like structure. This pulls the target directly into the open mouth. And this is the mathematical model for this strategy. Here you can see the best position and the individual position. As you can see, they will move toward the one in front of it and move toward the food in a spiral bay. So you can see they will move toward the one in front of it and the food. That is the best solution. Similar search strategy is also used in whale optimization algorithm. This is the bubble net feeding that is used by humpback whale, as you can see in the whale optimization algorithm. Last search strategy is somersault foraging strategy. Here, goal is to optimize food intake. So when manta rays find food sources, they circle around the target, that is the plankton. Suppose this is the target. This strategy is random, frequent, local, and it contains cyclical movements, and this helps manta rays to optimize food intake. So in this case, each individual swim to new position and position is updated around the best solution found. Here you can see individual position, and this is the best solution found. So here we will update the position according to the individual position and the best solution found. Here we have basic steps used in this algorithm. First, we will initialize the population, that is the population size. So first we have initialization phase. Here we will initialize the population size for the manta rays. Next, maximum number of iterations, then compute the fitness value for the each search agent, find out the current best solution in the population. Then check the stopping criteria. If stopping criteria is matched, then display the best solution that you found in the previous iteration, else move to this step. Here, we will check whether the random value is less than 0.5 or not. If this condition is true, then we will perform cyclone forcing, else chain forcing. And then we will compute the values for the each individual and then select the best solution. After that, we will perform the somersault forcing, then again compute the fitness values for the each search agent and then select the best solution among all. And again, we will repeat this loop until the stopping criteria is met, and then in the end we will print the best solution and its position. So that's all about this algorithm. In the next video, we will try to understand how this algorithm is working with numerical example and source code. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.